Okay, so there's two holes in this grommet through the firewall. I put it on the leftmost one and kind of curved more to the left so as to not run into the wire harness. Definitely don't want to poke that. Hard to see, but it's poking there. Got the wire poker up. Now I'm just gonna take this, stab it on here really good, and tape it, add some more tape, a lot of tape, tape it really tight. Then add some lubricant, Vaseline if you have it, maybe a little bit of PB Blaster, then pull it through. Just a little bit of WD-40, came right through. Fuse block on the left side, number 13, is our audio. I'm gonna test that for accessory power, use that for our remote turn on for the amp. So it turns out this whole fuse block is constant power. So, can't use that. Don't even try. This is the amp under the passenger seat in the front. They really did not make it easy. I don't have the tool to take the seat out, and I really don't want to take the seat out. The fuse block in the engine bay is all pretty much constant, except for a few, but I really don't want to mess with them. I can't run the wire out of the sealed box unless I drill a hole through it and put a grommet through it, which don't want to do that either. But see if I can find another accessory. Just ran it through the firewall, down the passenger, or the driver sill panel, under the B pillar, straight through, up under this seat, straight through the back, and it comes right out right here. Now I'm going to start the actual amp install. For reference, these latches are under the seat and they clip in right there. You can't just pull the seat up, you gotta turn these like this towards the outside of the door for them to release. They're quite tight, so be patient. Gotten this back cover off to this small speaker, small subwoofer for the BOSE system. Now I gotta figure out the polarity. Just gonna pop the speaker. We've got the negative lead on the brown wire. Let's see if I can do this. It extrudes out, so that means that's positive. I'm shooting 12 volts. And it's popping out. I'm on the brown, white wire is positive. Or the tan, actually. Tan wire. Negative lead on the darker brown wire. So, negative, positive. Alright, I've got everything ready to go. Just got to start putting the interior back together and then hook up the amp. Just tee it into the factory sub signal. Just want to see what it sounds like. Just an experiment. Probably going to end up using a full range signal. End up going to the amplifier. Got my RCAs. And I'm using signal sensing on the amp, so I don't have to run the remote turn on wire, which is nice. Ground wire to the factory ground. And then the main 12 volt coming up here. Gonna make everything nice and neat, put everything back together, and hook up the amp. All right, got everything cleaned up. Put in these two Sony 10 inch woofers. Just to a Kicker CXA300. Like I said, pretty simple. Just kind of threw it in there, just trying to do an experiment, see what it sounds like. This isn't permanent. I'm gonna build a custom enclosure for this car and do another video about that. And probably use a different amp, a little better quality. But yeah, it works.